resonator. And the third one is pumping source. Okay, so main components of laser. There are three main components in every laser. There are three main components. Without those components, the laser is difficult to be fabricated. The three main components is, first is the active medium, second is the resonator, and the third is pumping source. Now, what is the active medium? Active medium is of which material you are fabricating a laser. Okay, whether it is liquid, solid or gas, all the three types of lasers are possible. So active medium gives that of which material we are making that laser. Resonators, what are the role of resonators? Resonators are nothing but the mirrors. And if it is solid, suppose we are taking a something, you know, solid base as active medium, then these mirrors can be made just by polishing the ends also. So these resonators are nothing but mirrors. What is the role of mirror? Suppose when you just go in any sort of exhibition and there are so many mirrors that are surrounded in a small space, you know, just one in front of you, the other back and the side. What we see are lots of images, right? And if you just switch on a torch over there, or you just point a torch to one mirror, what will happen? The intensity you can see everywhere, and the intensity of the torch is more. The output you are getting is more. Why? Because now the intensity of the torch is striking to the many mirrors. Okay? The same is over here. A similar process. Not same, but the similar process. When there will be an intensity, because active medium will give that process of stimulated emission and absorption, spontaneous emission and stimulated emission. And after emission, what we are getting? We are getting radiation. If that radiation will strike between these two resonators, what will happen? If they are striking between the two mirrors, the light will amplify. So we wrote over here, no? Light amplification by stimulated emission. So how the light is amplifying? The light is amplifying with the help of these resonators. Okay, so the resonators plays very important role in laser, like stimulated emission. And for stimulated emission, what is required? Absorption. And which process gives that absorption? Which process gives that number of atoms should be there in the higher energy states? That is that pumping source. Okay, therefore these three are the main components. The pumping source, if there will be no pumping source, no absorption, the number of atoms will not move to the higher energy level state. If the number of atoms will not move to the higher energy level state, then you cannot have the process of stimulated emission, not even spontaneous. But in laser, we need stimulated emission. So we need number of atoms to the higher energy state. And if you are not taking active medium, you don't know which laser you are fabricating. Therefore, all these three components are very, very important. So I'll just jot down the three components. First is active medium. The material by which the laser is being fabricated with will. Second is resonators, the mirrors that are used. Sometimes in some lasers, external mirrors are not required. The ends are just polished. And the third is pumping source. The number 1, 2, 3 is not deciding their, you know, they are not deciding their priority. All the three are very important. Okay, so these are the three main components of laser. Rest. Next, we'll be talking about principle of laser. What is the principle of laser? There are again three main principles of laser. Okay, the first is active medium, second is